Hi everyone, welcome to JustFeg Network TV, a place where you can get the latest information on things happening around the world, and you are in the right place. Please click the red subscribe button and also press the bell icon next to it so you can be notified for an update on any published news. The leader of the Indigenous People of Biafra, IPOB, Nnamdi Kanu, has released the names of Nigerians who will be attacked on foreign land. According to the IPOB leader, all governors in the Southeast Geopolitical Zone and the President General of the Owanze Indigbo, Chief Inaha Owodu, will be treated like this, like the former Deputy Senate President Ike Ekweremadu. Southeast comprises of 5 states, Abia, Enugu, Ebonyi, Anambra, and Imo. Governors in the regions are Okezie Ikpezu of Abia, Lawrence Ifeanyi Uwangu of Enugu, David Uweze Umahi of Ebonyi, Willie Obiano of Anambra, and Emeka Idoha of Imo. Record that Ekweremadu was attacked at an event in Nuremberg, Germany, by an angry mob who claimed to be members of the secessionist group IPOB. The Nigerian government, members of the National Assembly, and other notable Nigerian politicians had condemned the attack, describing it as an international embarrassment. But reacting via his Twitter handle, Nnamdi Kanu said he had ordered its members in 100 countries across the world to attack all Igbo governors if they are seen in any of the countries. He tweeted, "The courageous act by IPOB at Nuremberg, Germany, is a polite warning to those engaged in selling our collective interests to Fulani Caliphate. Uwondo, Igbo governor, are warned. Join me via Radio Biafra." He recalled that the IPOB leader issued a strong warning to the governor of Ebonyi in one of his tweets on August 13, where he described Governor Umahi as a traitor. The shameful news that Dave Umahi wants urged IPOB to remain proscribed in the face of Fulani violence and threat of invasion by terror herdsmen in Southeast is yet another affirmative evidence of his prominent role in bringing fight-term dance to our land. The price for treachery is dead. In 2016, Operation Fight-Em Dance was launched by the Nigerian Army in Southeast Geopolitical Zone in the wake of protests by IPOB members who were demanding secession from Nigeria. Meanwhile, the Southeast Governors Forum has said that the attack on Southeast notable men and women would not solve the problems of the agitations for Biafra. The chairman of the forum, Governor David Umahi, said that the governors had no problem with the members of the outlawed group to warrant such an order, adding that the insecurity in the Southeast was a nationwide challenge, which was squarely under the federal government's command and control. Thanks to all my viewers today. So to my own opinion, I believe attacking these people outside the country will complicate issues. We just have to take it easy with them, because this is not, when you say you're attacking these people outside the country, remember that this is not Nigeria. It is outside the country. And people that are doing all those things, the Nnamdi Kanu and co, has to be careful too. We have to remember deportation and all those things that could actually happen while doing all those things outside the country. Even though these governments, they have subjected the common masses to a place of hardship and poverty in our own land in Nigeria, and these people also, they've destroyed Nigeria's economy too, but we still need to remember that it is not Nigeria that people are attacking all these leaders. They want to attack them outside the country, which means they have to be careful in whatever they want to do. Thank you so much for subscribing to my channel. And if you are yet to subscribe to my channel too, kindly subscribe. And please drop your opinion below. Bye.